Okay, I got a cool clutch to pull. We're gonna set it up over here. But man, I just peeked in some eggs. Come Monday, I got some crazy thing that just happened. Okay, I thought I'd change it up. After all, the zoo's closed, so I might as well find a place different every time to pull the clutch of eggs. Now the question is, will she think it's a different place? I might get bit, because now she might have the advantage. I'm looking, she's looking more up at me instead of at me. Come on, girl. Come on. Whoop, whoop. Come on, girl. So, this is a Motley Sun purple albino. Is it a lab or purple? Wow, that's a dark lab. So, but look what she's got. Check out all these awesome eggs. Look at that. Not every egg's perfect. What do we breed it to, Tim?
A Motley Golden.
A Motley Golden. So we're gonna have a bunch of Motley Goldens and maybe Sunfires. Come on, girl, come on, come on. I'm gonna try to make a video of a bunch of different monitors at the zoo. I'm gonna do some tours at the zoo. And this one's tour number one, how to pull a snake clutch. Maybe you might not wanna follow my direction if I bleed. So, but I won't bleed. Come on, come on, girl. Come on, come on. I'm gonna grab these couple loose ones on top. And like always, we make sure they don't roll around. Come on, girl, come on. So always talking about all these genes, she's pretty mellow, and luckily she's thinking she's gonna stay mellow, but maybe I'm just being stupid because she's not totally giving me up. She's not totally acting normal yet. So the idea is real simple. We're trying to get all these special genes in. Tim, can you guys wanna pull that? I'm gonna show you guys what the father looked like. He's gonna pull out that snake. And I'm gonna show you guys a really cool snake that the father looks like. And you'll see why we're excited. Whoa. Am I getting a bit in the process? I got my big snakes behind me, the big cage. The funny part is, talking about big enclosures, look at this little box. You know why she's in this box? Because she would, the funny part is, the snakes in there won't even lay eggs because they're not comfortable. Snakes like small areas because in nature, everything's eating them. Just like these eggs, they have to lay a lot of eggs because everything out in the wild is always trying to eat a baby snake. And of course, when she gets this big, she's got the, and she's pretty much got herself to that point where she's not gonna get eaten by most things. And, but that being said, to get there, she had to, she would have had to in the wild dodge a lot of problems. Now this one's albino. She would have never made it out in the wild, more than likely. So there was never one of these caught in the wild albino, believe it or not, this particular color phase. So she's actually a man-made one. Now I'm gonna show you real quick. Check this out. This is the color of the father. This is literally a twin to the father, or actually a brother. There's a sister to that. So is that going to be cool? So these two together are going to make more of these. And if the father was head albino, which we're not sure of because we had two of them. One was, one wasn't. But we're pretty sure that we used the one that wasn't. So we'll end up with those. And we'll end up with 50% those. And then we'll end up another 25% of those will actually be super motleys. And so it'll be a fun little clutch. In the big cages, it doesn't work so good, because the big cages are so big that the snakes don't really have a place to hide to feel comfortable. So what I have to do, even in the smaller enclosures that we actually keep our breeders in, we put our breeders in there sometimes, but the funny part is they go off food, they don't wanna breed, they eat poorly. But when we put them in a smaller enclosure, they breed, they eat, they do everything. They're happy, we don't have to manipulate them in order for them to get the temperatures that they need or anything, because what we do is we just provide them with what they want and they naturally reproduce. A lot of people have breeding questions. You guys can drop a few breeding questions about anything you want. We can talk about it. But what the biggest thing is, this small box is literally inside of a cage, an enclosure that's only 3 times the size, but because the box is smaller, they always lay their eggs in the box. We don't put them in this box. They come in this box because that makes them feel comfortable and feel like they have a better probability to be successful. It gives them less area to have to defend. It gives them more cover for things can't get in at them. So if anything comes their way, they know they only have to cover the area. Now, if I made the box only have be sawed like this with only a little hole. Daddy would lay, if I put two boxes in, they would lay in the one that only had a little tiny hole and it was completely tight. Because that, but then guess what? Oh man, that'd be a nightmare to get out. I guess I could put a hinge top on it or something, but I don't want them to get so scared, because when they have all that cover, they actually get so scared that they actually become aggressive. And when the more open they are, the less aggressive they become in time, because they just get where they're just been so much of their life scared, they don't know what to do. I'm still trying to figure out how many eggs I got here. What do you guys think? Oh my gosh, that I just can't wait to go cut the rest of that clutch. Check her out, man. Her eggs are looking crazy. I gotta get how many there are. If all the eggs were fertile, I'd be getting another box out. But the good news is that also the eggs hatch better when they're nice and tight. It's kind of more natural. They have a membrane that kind of compresses on it, and that holds all this humidity in. They have to be at high humidity in the wild. That's talking about how unfair it is that snakes are. Imagine this. So this clutch would have all died because these infertiles would more than likely rot. Insects would come in, either rot the egg next to them and turn into just a big problem, and then animals would come, be a big problem. Now, if they were all perfect in the wild, we more than likely, maybe only one would even make it to adulthood in reality. And that would be a really good clutch, because you think about a snake like this, they're always threatened and endangered and on the verge of barely having enough to survive the wild. Well, one snake can live, can produce 500 eggs in a year. Well, if it produced 1%, that'd be 5 duplicates of itself. So if it made 2 males and 3 females, then it would exponentially turn into where there's snakes everywhere you went. But instead, what happens in the wild for real is that most of the babies end up getting eaten by crocodiles, rats, everything, birds, almost anything you can imagine. And so in captivity, they have it a lot better. And because of that, we take the eggs away for another reason too. This girl here can actually go back on food, relax, be good, and it'll literally not have any distress at all. So this snake will be completely back to normal. And a wild snake would be stuck out in the wilderness for 84 days with no food, only the water that comes by rain, fighting off animals just to do this, and they'd be stressed out the whole time. Even in captivity, if I leave the eggs with them, they grumpy the whole 3 months. They'll usually strike, as you've seen a lot of the videos. This one's very, very, very domesticated and captive. So let's see how many eggs we got here, for reals. So let's see here. We got 2, 4, did you guys figure how many eggs? I got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Ah, darn it. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38. Wow, I thought I was gonna be like 42, 44. So they're big eggs, so they look really good. Get ready for some cool looking snakes. Meanwhile, I got a clutch of eggs to cut, so get ready. Are you ready for Monday morning? Because Monday morning, 7 a.m. by 7 in the morning, I'll have a video up of some really cool babies. So get ready. Peace out, you guys. Keep living the dream, even if this COVID-19 doesn't want you to. You got to get up there and still swing, man, because another day's coming. We're going to get through this. Peace out.